Chris with Retro Crypt, back for another video stream. We're gonna go into Metroid 2, Return of Samus. Only play this very briefly. Never beaten it. The only two Metroid games I ever beat were the original and Super Metroid. So, we have to change that. The fact that you can't shoot diagonally is annoying. She does haul an ass, though. Are the save points. Doesn't really matter in this because I could always save regardless. Acid. So that's a dead end. I'm gonna see if that would refill my energy. I know I gotta beat a couple Metroids in order for the lava to drop down. I do remember that about this game. I know the suspension of disbelief and everything, but it's kind of interesting. It's like, how does the lava know that you beat one of the Metroids? Let me not try applying logic to an illogical situation. It's just interesting to note. this game's like linear in a sense where you just can't get down to a new area unless you beat the Metroids of that area, and then you can proceed. It's not open world in a sense. It's not like a true typical Metroidvania where it's somewhat open world and you need... I mean, I guess it's sort of kind of the same thing in a way. Instead of acquiring items to unlock a certain area, it's like you destroy a Metroid and then the lava drains down. And that enables you to explore new areas. Little too dark. I liked it, but it's kind of weird that you can't see me. Platforming 101. Bring me back. Yeah. they're kind of laying the upgrades on kind of thick. For today. Got a bunch of upgrades, exploring, etc. Looking forward to coming back to this tomorrow. Later.